Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan. I am happy to meet you again through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. This is module 1, conduction heat transfer. Lecture number 1, the topic what we are going to discuss today in this lecture is governing equation of conduction heat transfer in Cartesian and polar coordinates. We are going to derive the governing equation for conduction heat transfer in the Cartesian coordinates, cylindrical coordinates, and the spherical coordinate system. And we will simplify this equation for a specific situation. We recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discussed the different modes of heat transfer. We just recall conduction mode, convection mode, and the radiation mode heat transfer. And we recall the Fourier law of heat conduction. The governing equation for conduction heat transfer is given by the Fourier, which gives Q equal to minus Ka into dT by dx. So K is the thermal conductivity, area A is the area normal to heat transfer, and dT by dx is the temperature gradient in the x direction. And as a learner, the student, at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to derive the heat conduction equation in Cartesian polar coordinates. And the student will be able to write the conduction equation for a specific criteria or specific conditions. Conduction heat transfer is actually a three-dimensional. Conduction heat transfer in any solid is three-dimensional time-dependent process. So the number of variables for conduction heat transfer are 4 in a particular solid. The 3 spatial coordinates and the 1 time parameter. In Cartesian coordinate system, in the case of a slab rectangular coordinate system, x, y, z are the directions, and cylindrical coordinate system, r, theta, z. R is the radial direction, theta is the asymptotal direction, and z is the axial direction. And in spherical coordinate system, r is the radial direction, phi is the polar direction, and theta is the asymptotal direction. So these are the 3 directions. And in all the 3 geometry, 3 shapes, the time parameter is also there. Why we have to do this analysis? What is the objective of the heat conduction analysis? As a mechanical engineer, we have to understand the temperature distribution in a piece of metal during a heat treatment process or any application. If we want to build a structure, we require material, and we should know the temperature distribution within the metal. So what do you mean by the temperature distribution? The temperature at any particular location with respect to time. You can divide the entire geometry, entire object into number of coordinate points. And we should know what is the temperature at different points within the solid at different time. So that is what the objective of conduction heat transfer analysis. We have to determine the temperature distribution within the solid. From the temperature distribution, we can determine the rate of heat transfer, thermal stresses, and based on the thermal stresses and the rate of heat transfer, we can select the material for a particular application. So the heat transfer, it helps you to select the material for a particular application. So the first topic, the heat conduction equation in the rectangular coordinate system, we take a slab or a cube of dx, dy, and dz thickness in x, y, z direction. So dx is the thickness in the x direction, dy is the thickness in the y direction, and dz is the thickness in the z direction. And Q, the heat is entering in all the, there are six faces in the slab or the cube. The heat is entering in the x direction, heat is leaving in the x direction, the heat is entering in the y direction, and heat is leaving in the y direction, the heat is entering in the z direction and leaving in the z direction. So in our three phases, out of the six phases, through the three phases, the heat is entering into the geometry solid, and the other three phases the heat is leaving. The heat entering here in the x direction is qx and leaving on the x direction is qx plus dx. So dx is the thickness of the solid in the x direction. Qy is the amount of heat entering in the y direction, and qy plus dy is the amount of heat leaving in the y direction, where dy is the thickness in the y direction. Qz is the amount of heat entering here in the z direction, and qz plus dz is the amount of heat leaving on the z direction, and dz is the thickness in the z direction. And here, if you take the x direction, the area normal to heat transfer, it is a thickness in the y direction, z direction, and thickness in the z direction, the y direction and the z direction. So the area for the heat flow in the x direction is dy and dz, dy into dz. Similarly, the area for the heat flow in the y direction is dx, dz, and the heat transfer area for the heat flow in the z direction, dx and dy. So this is the phase through which the heat is entering, and this is the phase through which heat is leaving in the x direction. So in the rectangular coordinate system, the temperature at any particular position within the solid is a function of x, y, z and t. So t is a function of three spatial coordinates and time parameter, temporal coordinate. And we determine one by one. So first we determine the amount of heat entering into the element. So in the x direction, so you recall the Fourier law, Q equal to minus K A dT by dx. Minus K is the constant, dou T by dou x in the x direction, and dy dz is the area for the x direction. Why this dou T by dou x? Now the heat temperature is a function of four variables, so we introduce the partial derivative. So dou T by dou x. Minus K into A into dou T by dou x. So A is the area in the x direction, normal in the x, normal to the x direction, which is dy and dz. Similarly, qy equal to minus k into dou t by dou y is the temperature gradient, and the area in the y direction is dx into dz. Similarly, qz equal to minus k into dou t by dou z is the temperature gradient, area is dx dy. So the amount of heat entering in the x direction, y direction and the z direction. The amount of heat generated, amount of heat stored within the element. So there actually, because of the heat transfer, the amount, certain amount of heat is stored within the element, which is given by rho c into dou t by dou t into volume dx, dy and dz. So the rho into c that shows the heat storing capacity of any solid into volume into change in temperature with respect to time. Temperature change with respect to time in the elemental volume. So rho is the density of the material, C is the specific heat of the material. And the heat leaving the element, what is the amount of heat leaving the element? So we said qx plus dx. So the first derivative, so qy plus x plus dx equal to qx plus dou qx by dou x into dx. So substituting for qx minus k into dou t by dou x dy dz, and substituting, differentiating this with respect to x, again minus k into dou square t by dou x square dx dy dz. So this is qx plus dx. Similarly, qy plus dy equal to qy plus dou qy by dou y dy equal to minus k into dou t by dou y into dx dz, that is qy, and the derivative minus k into dou square t by dou y square into dx dy dz. Qz plus dz equal to qz plus dou qz by dou z dz, where equal to qz equal to minus k into dou t by dou z dx dy minus derivative minus k into dou square t by dou z square dx dy dz. So this is the amount of heat leaving in all the three directions. And heat generated within the element, which is q dot equal to q dot into dx dy dz. So that is heat generated. Q dot is the rate of heat generated per unit volume in watts per meter cube, and dx dy dz is the volume of the element. And the energy balance, writing the energy balance for the element. What is energy balance? Net energy entering into the element is equal to net energy leaving the element. So energy conducted into the element plus energy generated within the element is equal to energy conducted out of the element plus energy stored within the element. So substituting everything, Qx plus Qy plus Qz is the amount of energy conducted. Q dot dx dy dz is the amount of energy generated. Qx plus dx, Qy plus dy, Qz plus dz is the amount of heat conducted out of the element. And rho c into dou t by dou x into dx dy dz is the amount of energy stored within the element. And substituting for this Qx plus dx, Qy plus dy and Qz plus dz. So Qx, Qy, Qz, the heat generated. Qx plus dou Qx by dou x dx plus Qy plus dou Qy by dou y dy plus Qz plus dou Qz by dou z dz plus rho c into dou t by dou t dx dy dz. Now comparing, just look at the right hand side, left hand side. Qx is getting cancelled, Qy is getting cancelled, Qz is getting cancelled. So finally, what is left out? So Q into dx dy dz, substituting for dou Qx by dou x, it is minus k into dou square t by dou x square plus d into dx dy dz. Substituting for dou Qy by dou y dy equal to minus k into dou square t by dou y square dx dy dz. And substituting for dou Qz by dou z dz equal to minus k into dou square t by dou z square dx dy dz plus rho c into dou t by dou t dx dy dz. So in all the term, dx dy dz is common, that is getting cancelled. So finally, so q equal to q dot equal to minus k into dou square t by dou x square minus k into dou square t by dou y square minus k into dou square t by dou z square plus rho c into dou t by dou t. Now the first three terms on the right hand side is taken to the left hand side. So finally, I will get k into dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q dot equal to rho c into dou t by dou t. So differentiating by dividing by k throughout, so we will get dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q dot by k equal to rho c by k into dou t by dou t. And this rho c by k is converted into 1 by alpha, where alpha is the thermal diffusivity, which is k by rho into c. So the final governing equation in the Cartesian coordinate system, dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square plus dou square t by dou z square plus q dot by k equal to 1 by alpha into dou t by dou t. So this is the final equation, the Cartesian coordinate system or rectangular coordinate system or in a slab. So here, the important parameter is alpha, thermal diffusivity, so which is k by rho into c. So k is the property, rho is the property, and c is the property of the material. So thermal conductivity, density and specific heat, all the three are the property of the material. So thermal diffusivity is also the property of the material, which takes the unit meter square per second. So thermal diffusivity in heat transfer analysis, thermal diffusivity is the thermal conductivity divided by density and specific heat capacity. It measures the ability of the material to conduct thermal energy relative to its ability to store the thermal energy. So look at this equation. K is the capacity to conduct heat energy. Rho c is the capacity to store the heat energy. So rho c, it is the capacity for storing the heat energy here. So it takes the unit in the SI system as meter square per second. And alpha equal to k by rho c. So k is the thermal conductivity, rho and c is the heat capacity, storing capacity. So what is the significance of this thermal diffusivity? So higher the thermal diffusivity, the heat conduction will be more. So numerator will be is higher, so there will be more heat conduction. lower the value of alpha, the heat stored by the material will be higher. So heat stored within the element will be more. So higher the thermal diffusivity, there will be more heat conduction. Lower the thermal diffusivity, lesser heat conduction or heat stored within the element will be more. So that is the significance of the alpha, that is thermal diffusivity of the material. And these are all the some of the properties, some of the material with its thermal diffusivity: aluminium 0.34, lead 0.086, and if you look at the insulating material, asbestos 1 × 1.04 × 10⁻³, and you take the dry air, which is 77.1 × 10⁻³, and water it takes 5.15 × 10⁻⁴ m²/s. So all these values you need not mug up and remember. So all these values are available in the heat and mass transfer data book, so we can conveniently refer to it when we design or solve a problem on the heat transfer. And now we will simplify. The first simplification, we find the governing equation for one dimensional steady state heat conduction without internal heat generation. So one dimensional steady state heat conduction without internal heat generation. So what are the terminology, what are the terms? There are 5 terms here. What are the terms to be deleted or dropped? It is one dimensional, so we take, there are 3 dimensions, we take only one dimensions, we drop dou square t by dou y square and dou square t by dou z square. Steady state, so dou t by dou t we drop, right hand side becomes 0, and without internal heat generation q dot by k equal to 0. Finally, what is left out? Dou square t by dou x square equal to 0. Now the temperature is function of only one variable x, so we write as d square t by dx square equal to 0. So the partial derivative we can make it as a ordinary differential equation. So this is the governing, this equation will be using for solving the heat transfer in a slab. So this is the governing equation we will be referring in future. So the governing equation for one dimensional steady state heat conduction without internal heat generation. Similarly, heat governing equation for one dimensional steady state heat conduction with the internal heat generation. So this term will be retained, plus for heat transfer, heat generation, we retain q dot by k. So dou square t, d square t by dx square plus q dot by k equal to 0. And this q dot by k is again a constant. So it is a constant. Here again, the temperature is function of only one variable. And the governing equation for one dimensional unsteady state heat conduction without internal heat generation. So unsteady state, so we retain the right hand side. So one dimensional, we have only one term on the left hand side, dou square t by dou x square equal to 1 by alpha, dou t by dou t. And the governing equation for two dimensional steady state heat conduction without heat generation. So we take two dimensions, dou square t by dou x square plus dou square t by dou y square equal to 0. Now we take a reflections part. So far we discussed the derivation of heat conduction equation for Cartesian coordinate system or rectangular coordinate system, which is applicable for a slab. We just a recall, and we take a break. We'll try to answer the question. The first question: thermal diffusivity is a property of the material. Yes, it is the property of the material, because thermal diffusivity is a function of k, rho, c. All the 3 parameters are property. So thermal diffusivity is also property of the material. Write the heat conduction equation for one dimensional steady state in a slab, steady state heat transfer in a slab without internal heat generation. So if you recall and write dou square t by dou x square equal to 0, it is good. So you are clearly watching, listening and enjoying the lecture. And we take the heat conduction equation, the cylindrical coordinate system. We take a cylinder and the exploded view of the elemental, small element is shown here. And the 3 directions are R, Z and the phi. So R is the radial direction, phi is the asymptotal direction, and z is the axial direction, and t is the time. So there are four parameters here. Temperature is a function of R, phi, Z and T. So heat entering into the element. So now here look at the area. So this length is, this arc length is R d phi. This vertical height is d z in the z direction. This radial length thickness in the radial direction is dr. And area we have to calculate. So for example, for the radial direction, R d phi into dz. And in the axial direction, dr into r into d phi. And in the asymptotical direction, dz into dr by r. That is what the area. So we take one by one. So qr minus k into dou t by dou r. So minus k into r in area equal to r d phi dz. That is what the area. So qz, z heat entering in the z direction, minus k into dou t by dou z. So area is r d phi into dr. And d phi, asymptotical direction, minus k into dou t by dou phi, area equal to dr by r into dz. That is what the area. So qr, qez and q phi. And now heat leaving in the r direction. So qr plus dr equal to qr plus dou qr by dou r dr. So qr as it is, dou by dou r of qr. So you have to substitute for qr. So, substituting for qr into dr. Now, here within the square bracket, k is constant, d phi is constant, dz is constant. So, I take all the three outside, k into d phi, dz, dr. Now, what is left out inside the square bracket? Minus of r into dou t by dou r. So, first there are two terms, r into dou t by dou r. So, dou by dou r, I keep dou t by dou r as a constant, dou r by dou r equal to 1. So, minus dou t by dou r minus, I keep r, and dou by dou r of dou t by dou r equal to dou square t by dou r square. So, what is the heat transfer, heat leaving in the r direction? So, qr plus minus, qr plus k d phi dz dr. Within the square bracket, minus dou t by dou r minus r into dou square t by dou r square. Similarly, in the z direction, q z plus dz equal to q z plus dou q z by dou z dz. So, dou by dou z. So, q z plus dou by dou z of q z. So, q substituting for q z minus k into r d phi dr into dou t by dou z into dz. Once again, k, we are differentiating with respect to z. So, everything is constant. So, we take everything as a constant. So, k, r, d phi, dr, dz, everything is constant. So, dou by dou z of dou t by dou z equal to dou square t by dou z square. So, q z minus k r dou phi dou z and dou r dou square t by dou z square. Now, heat leaving in the phi direction. Q phi plus d phi equal to q phi plus dou q phi by dou phi d phi. It is equal to q phi. Dou by dou phi of q phi, substituting for q phi, minus k into dou z dou dz dr by r, dou t by dou phi d phi. Once again, look at everything. We are differentiating with respect to phi. So, the, all the terms within the square bracket are constant. So, k, dou, dz, dr, r, everything is constant. So, we take k into d phi dz dr into 1 by r, dou square phi by dou square t by dou phi square. Now, heat generator within the element, heat generator q dot into the volume r dr dz d phi, that is the volume of the element. And heat stored within the element, this equal to rho into c into volume of the element r dr dz d phi into dou t by dou t, change in temperature with respect to time. Now, the energy balance, heat energy conducted into the element plus heat energy conducted generated within the element, it is equal to heat energy conducted out of the element and heat energy stored within the element. So, substituting for all the term, heat energy conducted into the element, which is qr plus qz plus q phi, and heat energy generated within the element is q generated, that is equal to heat energy conducted out of the element qr plus dr plus q dz plus dz plus q phi plus d phi plus heat stored within the element. So substituting everything, so left hand side heat generator equal to Q dot into R dr d z d phi, and the Q R plus dr equal to Q R plus dou Q R by dou R dr, and the Q z plus d z equal to Q z plus dou Q z by d z d z, and the Q phi plus d phi equal to Q phi plus dou Q phi by dou phi d phi, plus the heat stored equal to rho c into R dr d z d phi dou t by dou t. So right hand simplifying, Q R Q z Q phi on both side getting cancelled, so I will get left hand side, what is left out, Q R Q dot R into dr d z d phi, which is equal to dou Q R by dou R dr plus dou Q z by dou z d z plus dou Q z dou phi by dou Q phi by dou phi d phi plus rho c dr d z d phi dou t by dou r. And substituting for dou Q R by dou R dou z, all the first three terms substituting, and you will get Q R left hand side as it is, Q R dou t dou R dou z dou phi, and substituting for dou Q R by dou R into dr, so we'll get K into d phi d z dr minus K minus dou t by dou R minus R into dou square t by dou R square, and similarly for z term minus K R d phi d z dr into dou square t by dou z square minus K into d phi d z dr into 1 by R dou square phi dou square t by dou phi square, and the heat stored within the lem. Now looking at the equation, in all the term we have dr dz d phi is common, so deleting, so that is again one more step I have taken. So here in the right hand side we have three common terminology, everything is taken out, K into d phi dr dz, and what is left out here minus dou t by dou r minus r square into minus r into dou square t by dou r square, so here minus r into dou square t by dou z square, and here minus r 1 by r into dou square t by dou phi square, plus the last term as it is. Now deleting the term, we'll get Q dot R into K into everything plus rho c R into dou t by dou R, and here taking the value within the square bracket to the left side, Q dot R plus K into dou t by dou R plus R into dou square t by dou R square plus R into dou square t by dou z square plus 1 by R into dou square t by dou phi square equal to rho c R into dou t by dou R, and this term dividing by R, dividing by R, so I take first this term and then Q dot by K, yes, Q dot equal to rho c into dou t by dou t, so this is just dividing by R, so dividing by the entire equation R, so dou t by dou R into 1 by R, R is getting cancelled, so here R is getting cancelled, here 1 by R becomes 1 by R square, so Q dot rho c by here R is getting cancelled. Now dividing by K throughout, so 1 by R dou t by dou R plus 1 dou square t by dou R square plus dou square t by dou z square plus 1 by R square dou square t by dou phi square plus Q dot by K equal to rho c by K into dou t by dou t. This rho c by K by rho c, it is alpha. So finally this equation is, so combining the first two terms, it will be 1 by R into dou by dou R into dou t by dou R. So first two terms are combined like this, and the remaining term 1 by R square dou square t by dou phi square and dou square t by dou z square plus Q dot by K equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. And this is governing the heat conduction in the R direction, and this is governing the heat conduction in the phi direction, asymptote direction, and the dou square t by dou z square governing the heat conduction in the z direction. This take care of the heat generation, and this is the parameter for governing the time dependent heat transfer dou t by dou t. So this is the governing equation for cylindrical coordinate system in a cylinder. Now we simplify the equation for different conditions. For one dimensional steady state heat transfer without internal heat generation, it is going to be 1 by R dou by dou R, R into dou t by dou R equal to 0. For one dimensional steady state heat transfer with the internal heat generation, The equation is 1 by r dou by dou r r into dou t by dou r into q dot by k plus q dot by k equal to 0 for one-dimensional and steady-state heat transfer without internal heat generation. This is going to be 1 by r dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. And these three equations will be using in future for derivation and solving the problem in cylindrical heat transfer. And we take the third geometry, spherical coordinate system. We take the three directions, radial, asymptotal, and circumferential. Right? So the spherical coordinate system are, in the spherical coordinate system, the temperature within the sphere varies with respect to radial direction, asymptotal direction, the circumferential direction, and the time, t. So, and we are not going to directly derive the equation for spherical coordinate system. There is one technique called coordinate transformation method where we can take the equation for Cartesian coordinate system and substitute x equal to r sin theta cos phi and y equal to r sin theta cos phi and z equal to r into cos phi and deriving, simplifying, we will get the equation. Straight away remember the equation 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r plus 1 by r square sin square theta dou square t by dou phi square plus 1 by r square sin theta into dou by dou phi sin theta dou t by dou theta plus q dot by k equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. So, do not worry, we are not going to remember entire equation and we will take the specific equation. So, for one dimensional steady state heat transfer without internal heat generation, so this equation you have to remember 1 by r square dou by dou r square into dou t by dou r equal to 0. And one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer with the internal heat generation, we have to add one more term on the right left-hand side. So, plus 1 by r square dou by dou r into r square dou t by dou r plus q dot by k for internal heat generation equal to 0. And the unsteady-state heat transfer, for one-dimensional unsteady-state heat transfer without internal heat generation, the equation, this is 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou t by dou r equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou t. So, these three equations will be referring, will be using in future for calculating heat transfer in a spherical system or in a sphere. So, we will take the reflections part. We just recall the lecture for the previous 20 minutes and we try to answer. Write the three directions of heat transfer in a cylinder: radial direction, asymptotal direction, and axial directions, R, Z, and phi. What are the three directions of heat transfer in a sphere? Radial direction, asymptotal direction, and the circumferential direction, R, phi, and theta. Write the heat conduction equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder with the internal heat generation. This is r into 1 by r into dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to plus q dot by k equal to 0. And if we remember the write the heat conduction equation for one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer in a cylinder. So this is 1 by r into dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to 1 by alpha into dou t by. So, these are the reference book I recommend, heat transfer by Senger, heat transfer by heat and mass transfer by Incropira David, heat transfer by Osizik, heat transfer by Bijan, and heat transfer by K. Karnan. So, this is my book, heat and mass transfer, published by Anuradha Publications, Chennai. So, you can refer to the book for detailed derivation and further explanation on the lecture. So, if there is any query, you can write to me and you can comment the video so that you can write all your comment. I will reply to your queries or comments. Thank you. We'll meet again.